Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. So today the topic of our discussion is Merton's strain theory. We are going to discuss its concept, definition, and ways to cope with strain. So let's start our presentation. Introduction. This theory was developed by Robert King Merton in 1938. He was an American sociologist, and the reason behind developing this theory was that he was trying to explain the reasons behind crime. Why do people commit crime or they are motivated to do criminal behavior? So this theory states that society puts pressure on people to achieve socially approved goals but lack means to achieve that goal. So what that lacking of means create a strain on an individual, and that strain leads an individual towards crime. He commits crime to achieve those socially approved goals. So this theory says is that there can be an structural strain. So what structural strain is? It is like how the structure of society is created, how the hierarchy of society is created, and that hierarchy lets an individual know what his or her needs are. Strain can be either individual strain. Individual strain means that pains experienced by an individual, or how he or she looks for ways to satisfy his or her needs. This theory says that whenever an individual feels strain, he copes with that strain in five different ways. These ways can be conformity, innovation, ritualism, retreatism, or rebellion. We will discuss those things one by one with examples. So let's start. Conformity. What conformity says is that in conformance, a person or an individual accepts the socially accepted goals as well as the means to achieve those goals. He is conforming all the means and goals of the society. He has basically a herd mentality to follow. The pressure is asking him to do all those things. So examples can be education or career. Most students nowadays opt for science subjects, but they don't have any interest in that subject. But why do they choose those subjects? Because of peer pressure or parents forcing them to do so. It puts strain on them. So what they do, they conform to that thing to reduce the strain. Or marriage. What the society defines a settled person in the community is that he is 27 years old, he is married, he has children, home and a car, is considered a well settled and well organized person. So that's quite a big goal for an individual to achieve. Innovation. And innovation means a person is accepting the socially accepted goals, but he is rejecting the means to achieve those goals. By rejecting means, he is going towards other means in achieving those goals. And we know that there is a lack of formal means in achieving those goals. So where is he, what kind of means he is trying? He is trying criminal means for achieving those goals, because ultimate purpose of doing all those things is that he is trying to achieve socially accepted goals. So examples can be dealing drugs to achieve monetary success. The goal is monetary success, but means, he is trying his own means, dealing drugs. Either stealing to achieve financial security. That's another example of that behavior. Ritualism. In this, a person rejects socially accepted goals but accept means. Like he is just doing a ritual, like any other ritual that we do daily. So for that example can be political ritualism, in which people participate in political system by voting despite the fact that they believe that the system is broken and cannot actually achieve its goals. So they are just doing a political ritualism. They are just going and accepting socially accepted means of voting, but they don't believe in that system because they think that it is broken. Another way of coping strain is retreatism, in that a person completely rejects socially accepted goals and also rejects means of achieving those goals. He retreats from the system completely, just like that person in the picture. And the fifth and the last one is rebellion. In this, the person rejects both means and goals of the society, but he tries to replace both of them. That's rebellion. That's the difference between retreatism and rebellion. In retreatism, the person has rejected both goals and means, but he is not trying to change the system. But rebellion, he is trying to completely change the systems. I don't think I have to give examples of the rebellion. We have seen it in the history. Whenever the rebellion has happened, it has changed the system, its needs and its means, everything. So that was our presentation. Thank you very much for listening, and like, comment, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.